We've been able to destroy them down to non-detectable levels. We will be releasing specific data shortly on those results, and we're kind of compiling the data now. These results are what we expected from our SCWO technology, so we're really pleased.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Steve Jones. He is the interim CEO of 374Water. And Steve, it's good to see you. How are you?
Good, Steve. Thanks for having me on today. I appreciate this.
Yeah, good to have you along. I know you've been just named the interim CEO. You've been in the role for about several weeks now. So I thought it'd be a good opportunity. I know you've been on the board since April, so you obviously have some familiarity with the company. But for those maybe not familiar, give me a bit about your background.
Sure. So I spent a large part of my career with a company called Air Products and Chemicals. It's a large industrial gas company and chemical company. Air Products was very successful at developing new technology and commercializing it. And in addition, back in the 1940s, when Air Products was created, they developed the on-site business model, which is very similar to 374Water's waste destruction services model, WDS model. And this is where you put a facility on a customer site and you provide a service. So I've spent years either negotiating or developing those types of projects. So it's kind of an interesting connection between, you know, my background and what we're trying to do at 374Water. More recently, I was CEO of a public company. Covanta was traded on New York Stock Exchange in the waste industry. So I know a fair amount about liquid and solid wastes and how to deal with those materials in order to destroy them.
Yeah. So let's talk a bit about 374Water, that you've now been there, as I mentioned, a few weeks now. So what's your impression of where the company's at and really about the commercial progress of the company?
Yeah. So I've been really impressed with the size of the market. This is a massive market. If you look at the waste treatment market, including destruction of PFAS, it's about $400 to $500 billion, which most companies, you know, would give a lot to have that kind of amenable market. Last week, I spent in Orlando, which is where we manufacture and operate our supercritical water oxidation technology. We call it SCWO. And these are the units that go out and destroy things like PFAS. And down in Orlando, we process biosolids for the Orlando's water reclamation group at their waste treatment facility. We're very good at destroying organics, including PFAS and biosolids, because we've been down there for a while and have really valuable experience. We're also currently making several important upgrades to these units, these SCWO units. For example, we're upgrading our reactors. We're improving the level of heat and energy that goes into the process and doing some other upgrades. So these are all are important as they relate to the conducting a performance test, which we call factor acceptance test, for our next really large project in Orange County, California, for the sanitation facility there. So we've been taking the opportunity to upgrade our facilities in getting ready for that process. And I think we're on the cusp of completing all that work and locating this unit to Orange County. And then lastly, I've been really impressed with the talent and passion of our team. These folks are very dedicated into making this company success. And so I got a chance, like I said, to be in Orlando and talk to a lot of the employees. And it was pretty exciting. They're a really good team.
I know, as you mentioned, the commercial activities are obviously key to where the company's going. Tell us a little bit about some of the ones that you have underway right now, other than obviously the ones you mentioned in Orange County.
Yeah, so we recently completed a project for waste stream destruction for the Defense Innovation Unit. They call it the DIU, at a clean energy facility, clean earth facility in Detroit, Michigan. The initial results from that test show the level of destruction for different types of organics. So think PFAS or granulated activated carbon or ion exchange resin and other tough to destroy materials, both hazardous and non-hazardous. We've been able to destroy them down to non-detectable levels. We will be releasing specific data shortly on those results, and we're kind of compiling the data now. But these results are what we expected from our SCWO technology, so we're really pleased. Also, we're working on processing AFFF, which is aqueous film forming foam, for North Carolina at one of our existing SCWO units, and we're starting that activity this week in Orlando at our Orlando facility. This further allows us to show the market that our technology is very effective at destroying these chemicals. And there's the thing about this, Steve, there's literally millions of gallons of AFFF in the US and even more around the world that needs to be eliminated or destroyed. As you said, I mentioned the Orange County sanitation deal, which we're excited about. And then shortly, we're going to announce another win we just achieved. But I'll wait till that press release comes out in a few days and people can see what that deal's all about.
Sure, makes a lot of sense. I know that, you know, as an interim CEO, you have a million things you need to get done for sure and look at and understand. But you obviously have to focus. So what are sort of the things you want to focus on over the next several months?
So I think there's two areas we need to improve in. And let me mention that both Air Products and Covanta were very good at continuous improvement. So tools like Lean, Six Sigma, and so 374Water will be similarly focused. So the first is we need to continue to improve on our throughput on our SCWO units. So we're spending a great deal of time and energy improving in this area. We need these units to process additional volumes of organic materials. And I noted, you know, some of the things that we're doing in some of the units already. We've got great results on destruction. And now we need to go up that continuous improvement curve on making sure that we can process more and more volumes of materials. And then secondly, we need to focus our resources. Like I said, there's a vast market for destruction of forever chemicals. And we need to focus our business development on those opportunities that are nearest in from a timing standpoint and deliver the greatest return of on capital for our shareholders. So I'm going to be spending a fair amount of my time getting the business team focused on those opportunities where we can be most successful, and I'll be pushing this focus over the next couple of months.
Okay. Lastly, Steve, I just want to ask you. I was in researching the company. I took a look at one of the news releases that you talked about. You filed a preliminary proxy statement in relation to a reverse stock split. So I'm just trying to get some insight from you as to why you're pursuing that option.
Sure. So our board believes that maintaining our listing on NASDAQ, which is where we're traded, is in the best interest of the company and shareholders, and it's prudent. So to maintain this listing, NASDAQ requires that the stock price trades above a dollar, U.S. dollar, for 10 consecutive trading days prior to January 12th, 2026. So obviously, our goal is to meet this requirement through normal business operations. But if we're not successful, the board felt it was appropriate to request shareholder approval to effect a reverse stock split to ensure that we retain that NASDAQ listing. The reverse stock split should lead to higher share price, which would allow us to more readily access capital and facilitate our future financing for our technology and rollout of our on-site WDS model. This is also a great opportunity, quite frankly, to attract a wider investor audience. Certain institutional shareholders, Steve, they look at companies and they'll only invest if the stock price is a certain price level. And so, we want to shoot for that larger base. And then I guess I'll say lastly, we filed the preliminary proxy statement last week, as you pointed out, because when you look at the SEC requirements and NASDAQ requirements, we needed to begin that process now. And note that, the shareholders will vote on this at the appropriate time and we'll see what their view is on this important decision. But as I said, the board thought it was prudent at this point to at least start that process.
Okay, it makes a lot of sense. Steve, thanks so much. Great to check in with you and get a little on your background and where the company's going. And we look forward to having a lot more conversations like this in the future. Okay?
Great. Thanks, Steve. I appreciate you having me on today.
All right, good stuff. There's Steve Jones, the interim CEO of 374 Water.